Retribution. Retribution. And in a blowout fashion, too. I'm not really sure if we'll go over the game log. It was just a blowout of a win. Yeah, Red Sox demoralized just did damage to the Baltimore Orioles. All right. You want to hear the final score? Hang on to your seats. The Red Sox final score in this Red Sox sim in game 6 of 162. Red Sox, 27. Orioles, 2. Yeah. All right. I'll just get into it. I'm not working tomorrow either. All right. So to begin with, Xander Bogaerts gets the scoring off with a 3-run homer, which scores himself, Jose Peraza, and Dustin Pedroia. Make it the 3-0 Red Sox lead. Then nothing in the second inning. Pat Valachia, the Orioles, does hit a solo homer, make it a 3-1 Red Sox lead. Pat Valachia. How? He's not even that good. Okay, so, and then nothing in the fur for the Red Sox. The offense kind of just went a little dead after that, or dead in the second and third inning. So, and then the Orioles do score another run to even up the score 3-2 as former Red Sox Jose Iglesias doubles in center field to score Hanser Alberto, make it a 3-2 Red Sox lead. But that's where the only runs the Orioles would score, because after that, it was Red Sox all the way. In the fourth inning, this is where the real barrage began. All right. Let's see. So Michael Chavis homers into center field. Then Jackie Bradley Jr. homers. And then JD Martinez doubles into center to score Peraza and move Dustin Pedroia the third. And then a sac fly by Alex Verdugo scores Pedroia, make it a 7-2 Red Sox lead. Then, let's see, in the fifth inning, Michael Chavis homers again, his second home run of the night, and second of third of the homers they hit tonight. But, oh, yeah, spoiler alert. Yeah, all right, so make it an 8-2 Red Sox lead after 5. Then after 6, Xander Bogaerts grounds a single in the center field or in the center left field to score Pedroia and advance JD Martinez the second, make it a 9-2 Red Sox lead. Then in the 7th inning, this is where the real, that's right. All right, so let's see. Jackie Bradley Jr. homers solo. Let's see. Well, actually, no. Hang on. It was a free run homer. So he scores himself, Christian Vasquez, Michael Chavis. Then JD Martinez homers in the center field to score himself, Peraza, and Dustin Pedroia. And then Alex Verdugo goes yard. Homers. And then let's see. Then Jose Peraza doubles into left field to score Christian Vasquez. And our base clearing double, actually, I should say, scores Christian Vasquez, Michael Chavis, and Jackie Bradley Jr. Make it a 19-2 Red Sox lead. All right, and then in the eighth inning, more runs came. Alex Verdugo homered into a center field. Then JD scores himself and JD Martinez. Then Michael Chavis homers his third of the game, score himself and Bobby Dalbec, make it a 23-2 lead. Yeah. 23-2 lead. And then the ninth inning, Xander Bogaerts homers to score himself and Dustin Pedroia. Then Christian Vasquez homers in the center field to score himself and Alex Verdugo. make it a 27-2 lead, and that's where the final score would stand. As the Red Sox bounce back after they're suffering their first loss of the season, last time we were recorded. So, yeah. So, your player of the game is Michael Chavis, the Ice Horse. He went five for seven with three home runs and four RBIs. That is ribbies, yeah. And then Chris Sale gets the win, his second of the year. He went five innings. He did give up eight hits, though, but he struck out and he only struck out five people and gave up two earned runs. But he walked nobody, and it was good enough for the win. So good for old Chrissy Sale. Yeah. The loss goes to Wade LeBlanc. He lasted only 3.3 1/3 innings. He gave up 12 hits. He did not strike out a single person. He gave up seven earned runs, and he walked one person. He walked one person. Huh. Oh, yeah, it was the intentional walk. Intentional walk, yeah. All right, so a nice way to end the night, too, for me personally. Yeah. A package showed up late, and I almost was afraid that it wasn't going to show up. Yankees somehow survived to fight another day until I'm forced to game five tomorrow, which stings because I kind of wanted to see them lose, especially for guys who were parading the whole offseason after getting Gerrit Cole saying that they were going to win the World Series. Well, guess what? Your entire starting rotation stinks except for Gerrit Cole, and even he kind of stunk this year too. So that's what I mean. I mean, seriously, one guy is not going to win the World Series. And also, I was heading home from work. I get to a train or railroad tracks. The crossroads or beams go down. I thought, okay, a train's coming. I mean, real inconvenient. But there was no train that showed up for 13 minutes. And eventually the cross beams came back up. And I went on my merry way. So I was waiting for 13 minutes for a train that never showed. All right. Well, good thing Red Sox are in this game 5-1 now, so they bounce back, so they're 5-1. So very good. So looking for the series win next time around. All right. Good night. Banyana.